That's it. It was a lot back then, but in today's prices, not so much. It has changed hands a couple times since then. Most recently, it sold in 2008 for $3.2 million. A lot. I think I paid too much, but it's close to work. It's home. All right, a little song here for you guys. A beautiful day out on the lake. This is kind of the perfect song to play when you're on a boat. This is probably not the song you're thinking of because there's kids on board, but maybe the second best song to play. It's a classic. Enjoy. Unlike the rest of this tour. Now, over here on this side of the lake, we're getting a little broader view of all of the floating homes that we have here, all up and down this side of the lake. And all different sizes, all different types of design and architecture. Now here's the thing, the floating homes that we can see are actually on the end of their docks. The shoreline actually has quite a bit of contour to it. It's not straight across like these are. There's docks that come out from the shore, and the floating homes are as many as 8, 10, sometimes 12 floating homes on each side of the dock, and we're looking at them from the ends. So there's a lot more floating homes kind of going back towards the shore. We have actually 500 floating homes here in Seattle, all here on Lake Union and around the corner in Portage Bay. And that's a lot until I tell you that at one time we had over 5,000 floating homes here on the lake. And they started popping up when the city was first settled in the 1850s, 1860s. Logging was our main industry then, and tons of people were coming from all over the country to get in on that and make some money. And they had nothing but trees available to them. And they knew how to work with the wood. So those loggers came out here, they built their own houses. They took trees that they cut down themselves and lashed them together to make rafts, and then just built simple houses on top of those rafts. There was no property tax on the lake back then, so it was free for them to live, and that's how so many of them popped up here. But there's also no sewage system then. So we had 5,000 floating homes basically with a hole cut in the floor. You can imagine what happened. Everything emptied directly into the lake, right? And then Gasworks came along dumping a bunch of pollution, and there was a steam plant at the bottom end of the lake also dumping pollution into the lake. It was not a good situation. So after about 100 years of that, by the 1950s, 1960s, this lake was considered almost dead. Nothing really lived in it. It was so polluted, and it smelled like Tacoma. It was... That's not fair. Anybody on the duck from Tacoma? No? Okay. Oh. Okay. Oh, they are. All right. Well, then, so you know. It's exactly how it's not. Now... No, it was in bad shape. So, by the mid-60s, or, you know, 50s, 60s, mid-century, the city wanted to clean things up because of a little thing called the World's Fair was coming to town. Like, all eyes were going to be on Seattle. Their initial idea was to get rid of all of the floating homes. Now, they were pretty much shacks to begin with.